So you want to know about RNA, but you're completely in the dark about what it is? No worries, you've come to the right place. Here at the RNA Institute at the University of Albany, we're dedicated to discovering how to use RNA to target the most serious human diseases, such as breast cancer, Alzheimer's, HIV, and many others. So let's see if we can shed some light on how RNA works. Everyone has heard of DNA. It's the blueprint for all living things. But in order to actually turn those genetic plans into, say, a plant, a porcupine, or even a person, DNA relies on a close chemical cousin, RNA. You see, RNA is basically responsible for making copies of specific pieces of those DNA blueprints, and then using those copies to assemble all sorts of proteins that make, well, you, and everything else that's alive. Let's imagine an automobile factory. In this factory, they're producing complex cars made of lots of interconnecting parts. Now, if you were to go inside the factory, you'd find the car designer. He's our DNA. Let's call him Don. Now, Don has thousands and thousands of designs for every little detail of exactly how each car will work, bumper to bumper. But the problem is, Don can't actually build the car himself. In fact, Don never leaves the design room. So how do the cars get built? Well, there's another worker who can turn Don's designs into a product. His name is Ron, and he represents RNA. You see, Ron is a builder. First, Ron carefully copies Don's designs. Then he runs the assembly line where Ron and all of his associates build each car, all according to the plans. It's a great system, until something goes wrong. Suddenly, our cars start showing up with a defect, and these defects are like life-altering diseases in people, unexpected and unwanted. Sometimes there may be a flaw in one of Don's designs, or maybe Ron made a mistake in copying a particular design. So how do we fix these problems? Well, on the one hand, you could have a massive car recall. Each time a defective car shows up, you spend astronomical amounts of time and money to repair whatever effects those defects have. In other words, you treat the symptoms of the defect. That's the historical approach to medicine and research. On the other hand, if you could use RON, or RNA, to correct the source of the problem, then you could stop those defective cars from even being produced. Since RON is in charge of the assembly line, he can target the specific part that's causing the defect. It's a much more efficient solution. Now, no one knows exactly how long it will take to cure these troubling diseases, but we do know RNA-based research holds amazing possibilities. And that's worth dreaming about.